going on, smart people? New Master 69 here. If you watch Marvel, you might get the reference. Today we're going to be watching some Loki and breaking down the physics and some of the time shenanigans. There's a bunch of crap in it that we can talk about, so let's do it. Let's get straight into it. And before we do, if you want to win $500, all you got to do is four things. Takes you 30 seconds. Subscribe to my channel. Subscribe to my channel in the description. Comment down under and follow me on Instagram, where I'll be announcing the winner on the 21st of July. So let's get back to the video. Let's get straight into it. Welcome to my video, The Physics of Gardening. So what you want to do is you want to get a nice firm grip somewhere about here. So you've got some force applied to the rake and you want to get a nice technique going, something like that. And I don't know why this is so dirty. I'm kidding, guys. That is not what this video is. I'm just messing around. You guys clicked on this video for some Loki physics, so let's watch some Loki.
Get out of my way.
You're now moving at 1/16th speed, but feeling all that pain in real time.
All right, that one doesn't work. I don't like how she said real time either, because whatever time you're perceiving is going to be real time. It is very possible for two different people, two different objects to experience time differently. We've known that for a long time. But for the same person to experience two different rates of time at the same time, it makes not much sense. We'd have to get really deep into what time is, but we'll get there. So let's just gloss over that one for now.
Your little job, how do you like that?
So let's pause it here, because you guys are probably going to expect me to comment on every little thing. And unfortunately, we really don't know what time is. So I can't go around saying, oh, you can't do this and that, because we don't know, if I'm honest. So I can do my best, and there might be some things where I go, oh, that's not true, you can't do that. But really, we don't know. Maybe you can do a lot of this, like that thing with the colleges then. Obviously, my brain is going, whoa, you can't do that. But we really don't know. In physics, there's two grand, great theories, the pillars of physics, general relativity and quantum mechanics, and they both give contradictory interpretations to what time is. So we really don't know. General relativity, it looks like that's the one they're running with. But, I mean, she called him a variant. So I'm assuming there's some sort of multiverse shenanigans going on. Many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics. So they're kind of mixing quantum mechanics version of time and general relativity's version of time. Because in general relativity, you have this block universe where the initial conditions at the Big Bang set what's going to happen. And you live in this predetermined reality. So I say it must be taking general relativity's version of time, because they've got that collar on him and she just pressed a button and he came back. He came back to that spot. It's almost like she reversed his time. Maybe she reversed it. I was thinking maybe she, you know, set it to an earlier point in time. But he has memory of it. So maybe that it is just... Now it doesn't make a lot of sense. I've thought about it too much. If it's reversing time, that should also reverse his brain's chemistry and the neurons and his thoughts. So he shouldn't be able to remember that what just happened. Do you get what I'm saying? So he's run over there, she's reversed time, he shouldn't be able to remember. So maybe it's like transported in there, which makes no sense, because they're giving the impression that she's messing with time. So as you see, when you start to think about time, especially in TV shows, you run into problems really quickly. In quantum mechanics, time in that theory is very different, and the future is open. At every point, you know, there's a probabilistic thing going on. So the future isn't known, it's not predetermined. And our theory suggests that you can't actually know what's going to happen, which is a big problem, because physics is all about predicting the future. So yeah, that's the general way of thinking about time from those two interpretations. But hey, it's more fun to be a pirate than joining the Navy. Did you see the little cat? So that's obviously a reference to Schrodinger's cat. And I'm sure you've all heard of Schrodinger's cat and you know exactly what it's about. So I'll just give you a little fun fact. Someone made a real sized cat little thing and put it in Schrodinger's garden. And depending on the light conditions, it would look alive or dead. Pretty funny. So I'm sure you guys have all heard of it.
Please sign to verify this is everything you've ever said.
What?
All right. So this kind of proves that they're not running with Einstein's general relativity version of time, the block universe, because if that was the case, they'd already have printed off everything he said, because as I already mentioned, you already know what's going to happen. So this whole place would already know the future. So yeah, that doesn't make a lot of sense.
But then the all-knowing timekeepers emerge, reorganizing the multiverse into a single timeline.
Alright, so these timekeepers, it said they emerged after this multiverse war and brought the timelines back together. So where did they come from? They just kind of popped up like Jesus when they were needed? So does this kind of suggest that they're actually not all-powerful and there was... It's still not explaining where the universes and the multiverse comes from. So even, you know, wherever this ends up, this series, I think there's still going to be even, you know, more powerful beings in the Marvel universe because it said they just appeared.
The timekeepers protect and preserve the proper flow of time for everyone and everything. But sometimes people like you veer off the path the timekeepers created. We call those... variance.
Right, so this pretty much confirms that they're running with the quantum mechanics version of time, which is open, it's not predetermined.
The TVA has stepped in to fix your mistake and set time back on its predetermined path.
Hold up, they just said predetermined path, which doesn't make a lot of sense, because if it's predetermined, then how are the things slipping off? So they've already made a bit of a mess of it, unless these time lords or whatever they're called are the only ones who know, you know, the predetermined timeline or something, and for some reason this TVA place doesn't, which would make a lot of sense to me. You're going to have these timekeepers that are protecting the timelines, why not, you know, give them all the data or all the info? If that's the case and the timekeepers just aren't giving the TVA all of the information of the predetermined paths, well, there must be a very specific reason for that in the show. That probably means something bad for the TVA in the future, because, you know, why would you not tell them? It's probably for their own good.
How long have you been here? I don't know, it's hard to say. You know, time passes differently here in the TVA.
We can measure time, though, and the most precise instrument we have today are atomic clocks. And what they do is they look at cesium-133 atoms, which they kind of vibrate, right? And this vibration is always the same. And it's a very precise amount of vibrations. And, you know, once that limit is reached, we define that as 1 second. And that is about 9 billion periods of radiation between two hyperfine levels of the unperturbed ground state of cesium-133. I'm not going to explain what that means. It's just like the vibration of the atom, right? And you can't measure that very precisely, so you have to take a gas, you have to take a cloud of them and average it out. Now, I'm not going to explain too much of that, like I just said, but I will tell you something really cool, and that's that we actually have just designed an even more precise clock that uses quantum entanglement. And not only that, there's also another completely new kind of clock that physicists are trying to build called a nuclear clock. And this one will be entirely better than atomic clocks. We'll be able to test things like whether or not the fundamental constants of nature can change over time. There is some theoretical work to suggest that the fundamental constants of nature can change. And if this turns out to be true, well, you'd probably need to rewrite a lot of physics textbooks.
Long ago, there was a vast multiversal war. Countless unique timelines battle.
Okay, so they've mentioned the multiverse, and then you can bet there's going to be a whole bunch of multiverse shenanigans. So what is the multiverse? Well, there's about three versions of it. None of them have been... There's no evidence for any of them, all right? It's all pure speculation at this point. It's not really science, but it is fun, and it could be what the universe is really like. The first type of multiverse is simply that there are other bubble universes that we'll never be able to reach, or mini black hole universes. So like little universes inside black holes, and who knows, we might be living in a black hole currently. And I mean, if there are universes inside black holes, that would kind of mean that we're living in this infinite place, because you go through a black hole, there's a little universe, maybe there's some more, you know, galaxies and supermassive black holes, you go through them, there's some more universe and black holes, and you go through them, and it just never ends. Second type of multiverse comes from string theory, and that's because the string theorists can't seem to figure out how to get their models to predict the amount of dimensions that we currently see, which are four dimensions. We three spatial dimensions and one dimension of time. But in string theory, the best they can do is 11 dimensions, one being that of time. And so some suggest that if these dimensions are around us, well, there's kind of a whole lot more space, isn't there? So they think of it as this multiverse. I've heard some string theorists suggest, though, that these extra dimensions are very, very tiny and they're all wrapped up. But anyway, that's another type. And then the third type comes from the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, one that we've talked about many times on this channel. And again, it is pure speculation. This one is probably the most unlikely in my opinion. But what it stems from is our lack of understanding of quantum mechanics, essentially, and what it all means. There's a famous thing said in quantum mechanics, shut up and calculate, because no one really knows what it all means. It's all kind of weird and wacky. But anyway, it all stems from the idea of the collapse of a wave function, that when you observe something, particles that have this weird ability to be in more than one place at the same time, that disappears and you see them in one place. And it doesn't need to be a conscious observer. This can be anything doing the observing, another particle, for instance. And so every time there's a quantum measurement and you have this collapse of this wave function, instead of just getting, you know, this particle in one place now, what you really get is two universes. The universe is split somehow. Now you've got a universe where the particle, you know, landed over here, and a universe where the particle, the wave function collapsed and the particle's over here. So yeah, it's kind of like, if I've said this before as well, if you had a coffee and, you know, in one universe you've got a cappuccino, in one universe you've got a latte. And if you can imagine this to be another infinite place, because this is going to continuously happen and you're going to have infinite possibilities. So again, you're led to this infinite monkey land where you've got an infinite number of things happening. So yeah, I'm not too fond of the many worlds interpretation, but it exists, could be real, and there are some famous physicists that really like it. Now, I can't tell which version of the multiverse this show is running with. It could be a combination, so a bit of a multiverse going on. But if I had to guess, it looks like they're toying around with the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics and a bit of the first version where you just have these bubble universes. And I didn't say that these bubble universes might have different constants in nature where you wind up with a different sort of universe. And of course, we're going to find ourselves in a universe where the constants are just right for things like atoms to form, because, you know, we're here. We find ourselves here. So obviously that's the case. So if we really do live in a multiverse, what that means is there's other yous out there, not just other yous. There's an infinite number of other yous out there, which is awesome. So there's probably a version of me where I'm not in a garage and I'm in this nice, beautiful house. But anyway, let's not think about that. Now, could we experimentally verify this one day? Of course we could. But I have no idea how they're going to do that one. But I have no doubt that if it is the case, there could be a way to experimentally verify it. So don't throw any ideas like this out, as crazy as they might sound, because I think there's wackier stuff going on in quantum mechanics, to be honest with you. So I think that's enough for this video, guys. Make sure you subscribe. Do those four things if you want to win the $500. Comment down under if you want me to make another Loki video, for one. You've got to subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to the channel in the description. And follow me on Instagram, where I'll announce the winner on the 21st. So I'll see you next time, guys. Have a good one.